Hi everyone, it's Brett Williams from BretFX.com here. In this tutorial, I want to show you how to make an outline plugin like this one that you can apply to anything with transparency or an alpha channel like text or a graphic element or even text and a graphic element combined in a compound clip. We're going to make the plugin in motion, and when we're done, you'll be able to change the outline color and the outline width from your very own plugin right inside Final Cut Pro. So the first thing we need to do is switch over to motion. Okay, over in motion, go to File, New from Project Browser. I've already got the Project Browser open right here, and the next thing you want to choose is Final Cut Effect. I'm using 1080, HD 1080, and 2997. But you can use whatever settings are appropriate for you. Let's click open. Okay, so the first thing you'll notice is there's already a layer in here, the effect source layer. This represents the source media in Final Cut that you'll be applying this effect to. So for testing purposes within motion, we can grab a clip with transparency, or I'm going to grab a alpha channel PNG. This little airplane right here, and you can drag it. I'm just dragging it from the finder. You can drag it right to the effect source. So now I can start building my plugin and test it out on this airplane graphic. The first thing we need to do to start building our plugin is go down here to the upper right of the timeline to the filters menu, and we're going to go down to glow. Outer glow, that's the secret sauce behind Outliner. You can see it's already put like a yellow-orange glow around the airplane here. So with outer glow filter highlighted in either of our layer stacks here, we'll go to the inspector, and there's a couple parameters we need to adjust. First off is we've got two colors, yellow and red. We only need one color for our effect, so we're going to map the outer color to always be the same as the inner color, and we're going to do that with a parameter behavior. So if you move over to the far right of the outer color, you'll see this little twirl down triangle here. And click on that, go down to Add Parameter Behavior, choose Link. Okay, and you'll see Link appears right under Outer Glow in our layer stack. So now we've applied the link behavior, but we need to tell it what we want it to link to. Where does it want to get the information for that color choice? So we're going to drag the entire effect source layer over to the source object well. So now it knows it wants to grab the color for the outer color from this somewhere in this effect source layer, but it doesn't know what parameter we want to grab it from. So we're going to click on Compatible Parameters, go down to Filters, Outer Glow, Inner Color, All. So now if we click back on the Outer Glow effect, you'll see the outer color is the same as the inner color. And if we change the inner color now to say red, they're both red. And if you look over here at the airplane, it's starting to look more like what a nice solid color outline. Let's put it on white, since that's probably more appropriate for our needs. It's not very wide, is it? So let's make the radius 15. And you start to see a soft little edge. That's controlled by this range slider. So if we want a good solid outline, we want to turn this down to 0. All right, so we've created the effect we wanted. Now we need to publish it into Final Cut Pro. There's really only two things we need for a basic outline. The radius, the width of our outline, and we need the color. So first let's publish the radius. All the way over to the right of the radius, you see that same little triangle, go down to publish. And if you go back to the top of your layer stack, you'll see a layer called project. This gives you all the properties of your project. you know, 1920 by 1080 square, 2997 frames per second. There's also a pane in here called Project. And this is where you can test out the interface, and it shows all the parameters that you're building for your plugin, all your published parameters, and you can test it out right in here. This is how it will look in Final Cut Pro. So we've got the radius at 15, but perhaps radius isn't the right term. We're publishing an outline plugin. So let's double click on radius, and you can call it something else. Call it outline width. That's a little more descriptive. So now we've got one. We can test it in here. Whatever you set this to is going to be the default value when you open up your plugin in Final Cut Pro. So let's go back to Outer Glow, and all we need to do now is publish the inner color because the outer color is linked to it. So same thing, we'll click on the right triangle, the triangle over on the right, and click Publish. Let's go back to our project layer. The project pane is already highlighted. And let's rename this too. Let's call this Outline Color. And that's really it. We've created our plugin. All we need to do now is save it. Oh, we can also clear this out. If you don't clear out this airplane, it will show up in the thumbnail. Although it won't be applied to your effect, it will show up in the thumbnail in the effects browser in Final Cut Pro. So let's click on Effects Source. And go over here to the Image pane in the Inspector and just click Clear. Okay. Now we can go up to File, Save, and let's name our template. I'm going to call this BretFX Outliner Light. I think you would name yours whatever you like. The name is actually what's going to appear underneath the scrubbable icon in the effects panel. The category is going to be what's in the list on the left. So, since they're really one and the same, I'm going to create a new category and call it the same thing, BretFX Outliner Light. Now, if I had a bunch of versions of Outliner Light, for example, you know, thick, thin, I might want to break them up into different themes. Those are the categories on the right, you know, breaking up the different icons. For example, sometimes you see people with a bunch of presets for a plugin. A Clockmaker has a bunch of presets, so it's broken up into custom, which just has the one effect, and then another theme called presets, where you have all the different preset clocks. But since we just have one plugin here, I'm going to leave the theme at none and click Publish. So now if we switch back over to Final Cut Pro and we go down to the Effects pane, open that up if you don't already have it open, and scroll down, we should see there it is, BretFX Outliner Light. Right, so I've got a new timeline here. I'm going to drag that same airplane into my timeline. And I'm going to choose 2997. If we drag the Outliner Light plugin onto it, there you go. Up here in the inspector, you can see our two controls that we published, Outline Width. And Outline Color. Change that to something gaudy just to. And there you have it. You've created your own outline plugin. Well, I certainly hope this was of some use to you. If you'd like to be notified whenever I have tutorials like this available, or learn about the full Outliner plugin or my other effects and templates, head over to BretFX.com and scroll down to the bottom and sign up for my newsletter. Thanks for watching.